All right. So tomorrow, the Democrats who are not extremists or progressives, if Brown wins, are going to say, hey, guys, we got to triangulate. We got to move to the center. And they will find themselves in deep, deep trouble because their own president is not a Democrat. Remember, he was voted number one most liberal senator in America. But they used the wrong word. He's using the right one now.
If you're willing to get out the vote for Martha Coker, then you won't just win this election. You will carry on the best progressive, forward-looking values of this proud Commonwealth. To my progressive friends and to my Republican friends.
I've tried to emphasize to my more progressive friends, Tim and I share a philosophy. It's a pragmatic, progressive philosophy.
Did you notice when he was talking to Congress? My Republican friends, not my Democrat friends, my progressive friends. He doesn't care about the Democratic Party. He's a progressive. Let me give you a quick history lesson on how progressives operated when they first surfaced at the beginning of the 20th century. Oh, they were very popular then. We had the two-party system. We had the Republicans and the Democrats, conservative and liberal. But liberal at the time meant something different than it means now. Liberals then were for the little guy. Everything that you think and the stereotypical stuff, the liberals were for the little guy. The conservatives were the big fat cat guys, Republicans and Democrats. Theodore Roosevelt was a conservative Republican. Got it? Woodrow Wilson was a Democrat and a liberal. But then, around the turn of the century, they came up with a new idea. It was called progressive. Progressive was an umbrella, and it covered both parties. Woodrow Wilson and Theodore Roosevelt were both progressives. But then, after Woodrow Wilson, he did exactly the same thing. This administration is using the Wilson playbook. After the Wilson administration, people started to see who progressives really were. They brought the Federal Reserve, the progressive income tax, entry in World War I, prohibition, the League of Nations, which was the precursor to the UN. Well, after that series of debacles, they became so unpopular that it was like, okay, we gotta look. They didn't triangulate. No. What did they do? They slipped back into the shadows and they changed. They only changed one thing. The progressive label went away and they just became liberals. They still were embedded in the Republicans. But they co-opted the word liberal. At the time, the word liberal meant maximum freedom, limited government. You didn't really need a libertarian because you had the liberals. Libertarians. See what they did? They co-opted this. They embedded themselves in here. And they took the seat away from people who said very small government. Because it was kind of big government and really big government. Well, after the past 50 years or so, liberal became a bad word, just like progressive did at the early 20th century. They had corrupted the name liberal that nobody wanted to be identified by it. Which is why, when asked, Hillary Clinton described herself this way.
I prefer the word progressive, which has a real American meaning, going back to the progressive era at the beginning of the 20th century. I consider myself a modern progressive.
A modern progressive. Well, when are the good Democrats going to stand up and fight? They've been weakened through corruption, healthcare, bribes. They have taken the progressives and they have taken these people right where they want them. Mess with us? Oh, no. You're going to play ball. And if you don't, well, we don't need you anyway. We'll just find another party that will do it. Nancy Pelosi came out and she said she doesn't care if Brown wins or loses. Watch this.
I have confidence about tomorrow because I'm a grassroots organizer. It doesn't matter what the poll says. It matters who votes, and we'll see what happens tomorrow. But let's remove all doubt that we will have health care one way or another.
Okay, so here's Nancy Pelosi. You hear what she's saying? She's saying she doesn't really care what happens at the polls. One way or another, we're going to have health care. Okay, remember that. She doesn't care at the polls. FCC, They want net neutrality with Obama. That's his big push. Net neutrality. It's a way to control voices. The government regulations on the internet is what they want. If they don't get it, they just told the court, who said, I think we're going to rule against you. No big deal. We'll just find another way. The FCC will make the internet a public utility, and the White House will get its way. Cap and trade. If that doesn't pass, the White House has said, don't worry. Progressives aren't worried. They'll just circumvent the system and find a backdoor. The EPA miraculously declares carbon dioxide is a danger, and they'll regulate it. This is our system, gang. This is the way our founders put it together. Congress, the president, the courts, equal branches of government, and you are on top. But look what they've done. With Nancy Pelosi, she says, I don't care what you say. No, we're going to do it anyway, because the progressives want it. Then the court system says, yeah, you're not going to get the FCC net neutrality. And the FCC says, don't worry about it. The progressives want it. We'll do it anyway. And then, of course, we have Congress and EPA. Well, they're not going to pass cap and trade. Don't worry. The progressives want it. And they'll do it anyway. I don't know what they've done to our system. I don't recognize this system. It's almost like what we've been saying here. What these people want, they will get. This is not a democratic republic, gang. This is not what our founders set up. I wonder tonight if the Democrats realize they're on the eve of an internal civil war with themselves. Or are they buying that line from Obama that it's Fox News and the GOP that's causing all the problems and all the delays for progress? Well, if you're a Democrat and you're struggling with that one, I'm going to give you the answer in the next block. Don't miss a second of today's show. But let me leave you with this thought here. America, if these people are only politicians, they will do what they did in 1994, and they will migrate starting tomorrow right to the center. But if we're right that these are Marxist revolutionaries, that these are progressives who follow Mao, they are going to put the foot on the gas. It's not going to be pretty. And they will eat their own, the Democrats, first.